We'd like to start the regular press conference by Minister Motegi. Minister, the floor is yours. Last evening, I returned from my trip to South Africa. As far as the outline of the trip is concerned, about 2 days ago, I visited Mauritius, and we had an online press conference from Mauritius. That is all from my side. Thank you. I think we'd like to start the Q&A session. If you're designated, please use the microphone in the front row, state your name and affiliation, and then go on to your question. So let's go on to the first question. Mr. Kashimoto from TBS, if you'd like to take the floor. Thank you. Kashimoto from TBS, thank you so much. You visited the four nations, and you promoted the free and open Asia-Pacific. I believe you cited the importance of this initiative. Can you talk about the response of the people that you met locally when you visited these countries?
Well, this will be a repetition of what I mentioned 2 days ago in my press conference. Should I repeat what I mentioned 2 days ago then? Well, so free and open Indo-Pacific. In 2016, in Ticket 6, when this was held in Africa, this was promoted and a vision put forward by Japan at that point in time. Now the vision is now being shared by U.S., Australia, and India. And also, we are now sharing this with the ASEAN countries as well, and also the major countries in Europe, and also even countries in Africa. They're now showing support for this initiative. That is the situation. Now, I started my visit from Tunisia, Mozambique, and South Africa, and then went on to Mauritius. As a matter of fact, we talked about various bilateral issues and also addressed regional issues as well as global issues. And in that context, free and open, realizing delivering free and open Indo-Pacific, when I put this on the agenda, they all nod immediately and they all agree with this initiative. So free and open Indo-Pacific, this initiative. In the past 4 years, even within Africa, he has firmly taken root in Africa. And also through this visit, I have a sense that cooperation for delivery of these issues can be delivered with each of these countries. This was a major significance of my visit. Thank you.
Next question, please. Kato-san, Nikkei Shimbun.
Thank you, Kato of Nikkei Shimbun, a newspaper. Next year, Japan will be the chair of the TPP. The other day, President Xi Jinping expressed interest to join, and Moon Jae-in, President of South Korea, also made a comment that Korea will think. Thailand and the U.K., there are other economies who have expressed interest as the chair. How will you deal with these countries next year?
The TPP-11, they are a very high standard, well-balanced, 21st century type of rules that could be spread across the world. Indeed, it was Japan who led the negotiation, reached the agreement, and it has gone into effect. At this juncture, already some economies had expressed interest, like the U.K. and Thailand, and in addition to such countries, the countries that you mentioned, including Thailand. Indeed, a variety of economies have expressed their interest. This fact indicates how valuable and precious and how highly appreciated TPP-11 is, and I welcome this move. On the other hand, with regard to TPP-11, in terms of market access or in terms of e-commerce, intellectual property, government procurement, state-owned enterprises, or SPS. In such areas, these are all of very high-level rules. Whether these economies who express interest are prepared to accommodate all these high levels, we must carefully observe their situations. As was discussed, for each of the aspects, a variety of flexibility will be required for many economies to participate. In the case of Japan, as we will preside, As the chair, we will carefully follow the movement of economies who express their interest, whether they are prepared to adhere. We will take care, including our strategic perspectives. We will continue the effort to steadily implement and expand the TPP.
Next question, please. If not, okay, then next question. Sato-san, please. Thank you, Sato from TV Asahi. I would like to ask about your visit to the African countries. Next, after the new year, I think you're planning to, or maybe coordinations about the visit to Latin America as well. So you visited Africa, having visited countries of Africa, and the fact that you'll be visiting different regions after the new year's. In what way would you like to engage with those regions at the government of Japan? Can you talk about this outlook, please? Well, under the Abe administration, a diplomacy that takes a panoramic view of the world map had been promoted, and the basic thinking has not changed. Now, against that backdrop, as far as I'm concerned, I have been tolerating diplomacy with both strength and tolerance. Between various countries, we would like to enhance our bilateral ties. And also, based on international rules, how should we act? What are the actions required by the global community based on international rules? I think we have had very good discussions so far. Now, this year, we've had international conferences based on phone conferences have been held throughout the year. And of course, aside from bilateral issues, there's some delicate issues in relation to the global situation. And exchanges of views on sensitive international issues, this really requires face-to-face communication. I believe face-to-face communication is very important in that regard. In the international community, there are various countries with different views. There are countries and regions with different set of influences, level of influences. So meeting with the top people and the counterpart of those regions and spending sufficient time for discussion, I think, is a very important endeavor. Now, with regard to my visit after the new year, it has not been decided. Because of this perspective, we'd like to give this matter consideration. Thank you.
Further questions? Yes, Ishinabe-san, Sankei Shimbun. Ishinabe, Sankei Shimbun. Thank you. About the American electoral presidential election, the Electoral College voters started, and Mr. Biden effectively has confirmed his victory. What is your observation and your comment about how to develop the bilateral relationship with the new administration? In the case of this year, under the U.S. Constitution, the 14th was the day of the Electoral College vote, and on the 14th, indeed, the vote took place, and Mr. Biden won the majority vote and is almost confirmed that he will be elected as the new president. And the remaining procedure will be January the 6th to certify the accounts at the joint session of the Congress. Between the new Biden administration, there will be no change in the strong U.S.-Japan relationship. In order to strengthen the bilateral relationship, in order to realize a free and open Indo-Pacific, I wish to further closely collaborate with the new administration. As for myself, when Mr. Blinken, former Deputy Secretary of State, is officially take place as the Secretary of State has been nominated, I wish to communicate with him and further cooperate in order to develop our already strong bilateral relationship.
Anything else? If not, we'd like to conclude the conference. Thank you. Weren't you going to ask about this year's Chinese character? If not, okay, then please go ahead. Thank you. Well, and this is now the year end. If you were to use one Chinese character to express this year, what will it be? Well, no, this is a question that I thought that would be asked by all the ministers, so that's why I already had prepared an answer. Well, so Chinese character that represents this year. This year it has been designated as close. The Chinese character meaning close or congestion. Now, in a similar vein, in order to avoid congestion, maintaining distance between people. So I think it's a sense or remote. I think the Chinese character representing the meaning of remote would be the one that I would choose. Why? Avoiding congestion. I think in that regard, it's the same, I believe, in meaning. It is true that this year, because of the pandemic of COVID-19 and pursuing diplomacy was proved to be challenging. But despite that, with the new novel coronavirus spreading throughout the globe, even after summer, I was able to visit 16 countries even after the summer and had the chance to directly meet with the leaders and the foreign ministers of various countries and regions. And even after novel coronavirus hit the globe, we've been able to have increasing number of phone conferences. 109 phone conferences were carried out. Phone conferences and video conferences were held altogether this year. So visiting 16 countries. And even before that, I had the chance to visit 6 countries before that. So this year, I would have visited 22 countries. And 109 remote-style discussions were also held. So in a nutshell, yes. Even if we are distant, even we are remote, if you will, we are able to maintain close coordination. That was what this year was all about. Thank you. Thank you. With this, we'd like to conclude the conference. Thank you. Thank you very much.